Hey, welcome back to the Mr. Excel Netcast. I'm Bill Jelen. Let's get to the second part of Brent's question. Yesterday, Brent asked a question about data validation, which I could not answer very well. The second part is, hey, how can I set up my data validation lists that way they are on another worksheet? Well, generally, that's not valid. You're not allowed to have your data validation lists set up on another worksheet, so people always hide them out on the right-hand side, you know, way out in ZZ. Or you know, Z1 through Z99 or something like that. But the great secret is to add a second worksheet, and on the second worksheet, set up your list and make sure that the list has a named range. So for example, we might select this list and give it a name, my list, click enter. And then when we go back to the original worksheet, if we want to set up validation, data validation, allow a list, and the source is equal my list. When you set up a workbook name, it is defined throughout the whole workbook. And so that actually tricks Excel into thinking that my list is right on the current worksheet. We'll click OK. And sure enough, the dropdown now brings those values from the other worksheet. There's no chance that anyone's going to inadvertently delete a few of those rows that you're hiding out there on the right-hand side. Now, to make it a little bit safer, of course, you can go to Format, Sheet, and then choose Hide. And then no one will even know that the sheet is there with the values for your drop-down list. So great question from Brent. The simple solution is just basically to add a named range, and then you're able to point to lists on other worksheets. Hey, thanks for stopping by. We'll see you next time for another Netcast from Mr. Excel.